Hi, it's Channing Hanspal. In this video, we're going to look at my top 10 all-time favorite jazz fusion intros. In at number 10 is the Medieval Overture by Return to Forever from the 1976 album Romantic Warrior. I love the intro to this piece. It's really ethereal. It sort of has a otherworldliness to it. It's actually played on the Fender Rhodes, going through a delay pedal with overdub synthesizers. And the time signature is 2 bars of 5/8, 1 bar of 3/8, and 1 bar of 5/8. So it's like this: 1 2 3 4 5, 1 2 3 4 5, 1 2 3, 1 2 3 4 5, 1 2 3 4 5, 1 2 3 4 5, 1 2 3, 1 2 3 4 5, 1, and so on and so on. The chords are all major 7 voicings, so you have G, C, F, B flat, C, F, B flat, and then it goes to C, B flat, A flat, and the cycle starts again. Number 9 is Nautilus by Bob James. What I love about this one is that it has this really gritty, funky riff that's played by the guitar and the bass. And you have this sort of driving drum beat. Meanwhile, this very soft, delicate Fender Rhodes playing on top. It's quite interesting. There's a kind of a textural conflict there. The riff is... The piece is predominantly in the Aeolian mode. It starts off with a melody and then sort of goes off into the solo where James is playing around the Aeolian mode. Occasionally he goes into the harmonic minor scale. Number 8 is Contusion by Stevie Wonder. This track first appeared on the 1976 album Songs in the Key of Life and was really influenced by the jazz fusion groups of the time, in particular Return to Forever. The piece borrows a lot of the vocabulary from that particular genre, such as chordal ambiguity, changing time signatures, and whole tone step movement in the chords, this kind of parallel voicings. It starts off with these minor 9 chords. And the bass is holding a C root, so we've got some kind of C minor tonality there. He's approaching it from a tone above. And then the synthesizers come in and start playing these sus2 chords. Moving around in whole tone steps there. These major 9 chords move down in whole tone steps. And also the time signature changes. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. And number 7 is this one. Thank you. You could never underestimate the sheer musical power and energy of the Mahavishnu Orchestra. I mean, John McLaughlin really assembled a formidable band. John McLaughlin was one of the first larger-than-life jazz rock guitarists. I mean, he really set the standard, and this piece, Birds of Fire, is a really good example of how ferocious a guitar player he was. Piece starts off with a series of gongs, and the wash of the reverberation settles, and out of this comes this really sinister sounding guitar part. And as his guitar continues, the keyboards come in and double up on the arpeggios. This is then followed by these edgy riffs performed on the violin and the electric bass. And then the sort of thunder of drums come in, and then we're off. At number six is Refried by Tom Scott and the LA Express. Really cool about this song is the production. I mean, it's so warm. It's got this really wonderful warm analog sound and all the right instrument combinations and wonderful chords. And then you have that melody that's played on the sax and the guitar. It's great. It also features some great musicians. I guess the top LA session musicians of the time: John Guerin on drums, Max Bennett on bass, and Robin Ford on guitar. At number five is Lead Boots by Jeff Beck. The production on this album is also really cool. It's got this really hard-hitting compression, you know, everything sounds fat and upfront, which is quite interesting because it was produced by George Martin and Jeff Emerit, who were renowned for the Beatles recordings in the late 60s, so it seems quite a departure from those recordings at least. And it comes in with the narrator Michael Walden's drum intro. It's just fat-sounding drum beat he lays down. Jeff Beck and Max Middleton come crashing in on these dominant sus4 chords, you know. And you have that signature riff. And that signature melody. At number four is Kuru, Speak Like a Child from this album. It starts off with this fast minor pentatonic run played by the strings, and when they get to the end of the run, they just sustain the notes very quietly, and then this sort of percussion comes in, and It's sort of very reminiscent of sort of 1970s detective film soundtrack. The minor pentatonic riff that the strings play at the intro is very typical of Jacob Astorius. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know, he emphasizes every sixth note, so it's almost like he's implying quintuplets, but it's just a straight series of semiquavers. He does this in the Port of Entry solo as well from the Weather Report album Night Passage, where it does the kind of descending version of it. You can hear that in his solos a lot. It's a real calling card of his. And then Pistorius comes in with this this kind of hypnotic pattern that he plays throughout. And then Herbie Hancock's solo comes in. Number three is Palladium by Weather Report. Now, this track was actually written by Wayne Shorter. It has a very playful introduction. Wonderful chords played by Zovinal there. And then after these chords, there's just this moment of silence. And then. And just the way the band comes in, you know, Pistorius and his characteristic bass lines, and Zovinal playing these very sort of staccato-like chords, and Wayne Shorter's lyrical melody, beautiful melody. And number two is Lonnie Liston Smith. Now, Liston Smith played with Roland Kirk, Miles Davis, and Ferris Sanders, and during the 1970s wrote some really great modal tunes. His music was very spacey and dreamlike, I suppose, very smooth vocals, but with driving drums and bass. So it starts off with some percussion first, and then the acoustic bass comes in. Keyboards play that typical Liston Smith calling card there. You have the second and the minor third. Is Actual Proof by Herbie Hancock and the Headhunters. This is classic Headhunters groove bass central with Mike Clark on drums and a killer Paul Jackson bass line. Herbie Hancock sort of comping on top of all that. And then a melody that sounds like it's something out of Star Trek.